single day, more than 50 sewage trucks disposes wastewater at the Agua Gambia Kotu Pond. The largest foreign-owned pond that is partnering with NAWEC and NEA has been operating in the Gambia for the past 6 years to treat sewages around the surrounding. Over one-third of the global population do not have access to functioning sanitization facilities and sewage disposal. This lack of sanitization adversely affects social and economic development in the countries concerned and is also a source of significant environmental pollution. Agua Gambia is responsible for giving wastewater treatment facilities and all the connected sewage network in the Gambia. Contrary to their operations over the past years, one of the country's busiest industrial areas, Senegambia, has been affected by the bad odious pollution emanating from the pond site. Most developing countries are unable to properly manage the disposed sewage due to the absence of efficient institutions, lack of technological know-how of wastewater treatment processes and their implementation. Also, inappropriate management practices.
As far as the tourist season is coming to start, normally in all, we have four pump stations, like starting from Senegambia, we have a well there, a pump station there, where normally all the sewage from that area go to that well. That's called a pump station. That's where you go, and then we have a pump machine there. It puts it to the other pump station, and number two here, that is in Palmarima. The second pump station is there, and then we have another pump station behind the Combo Beach, and another one at DB. It's four pump stations. So all these hotels, each pump station, the surrounding holes is normally pumped to that well.
The process of waste dumping is currently causing environmental pollution, which is affecting hotel-owned business entities and the lives of people residing around the sewage treatment center in Kotu. Globally, tourism could lose around 120 million jobs as a result of the coronavirus pandemic, according to the World Travel and Tourism Council.